Welcome to part 3 of this video series about FortiClient installation for SSL VPN access. In this video, I'm going to show a couple of troubleshooting steps, how to troubleshoot the FortiClient when there is a connectivity issue, what we can see on the Fortigate or on the client. So on the EMS server, we can see that Aaron Kahn is away. He's not part of the corporate network, and DMS cannot detect the status. DMS has no visibility to the client. On the client, what you can find is that if the client detected that the user is or the computer is offnet, so it enabled the correct profile with the remote access with these pre-configured details available. All that the user have to do is just to type the username and the password and click on the connect, and that would initiate the SSL VPN session back to the corporate firewall and to establish the tunnel if the credentials are correct. Like in this case, we have the tunnel established and the user can now have access to the corporate network. Let's just have a look at the information and receive the IP address for the virtual tunnel SSL VPN interface. And as the next step, we can have a look at the Fortigate firewall. I'm using version 7.0.1, which is the latest version at the time of creating this video series. And we can go to the SSL VPN monitor dashboard widget. We can see the user logged in from that remote host IP. It started to generate some traffic. And if you want to see more details, then we just go to the view connection details, where you can find the tunnel IP address, the source interface, and the duration of the session. If you want to see the log events, then we can go to events and VPN events, and that will display both IPsec and SSL VPN information. Here we can see the tunnel was established by Acon user. Acon user is part of the SSL VPN underscore users group that we configured on the Fortigate. And it has a quite low security level, which we are going to improve in one of the upcoming new videos. So let's just do some troubleshooting to see what information we can collect on the Fortigate. Enable timestamp in the CLI so we can have dates and times assigned to each record, and to enable the debug level for SSL VPN application. And again, initiate the tunnel with incorrect user credentials. The Fortigate will display a lot of information about the SSL VPN and the user authentication itself. What we can see is some random user is trying to connect to our Fortigate firewall, and the Fortigate is trying to look up the user details in the SSL VPN user group, but it couldn't find anything. So the SSL VPN login received a permission denied error message, and at the same time, the user on the desktop received a credential error message. We can close the dialog, and on the firewall, we can see the session has already been terminated. See the difference between successful and unsuccessful authentication. Let's just use the correct username and the password. Again, the tunnel gets initialized. And on the Fortigate, we can see a different output. So we could find the user that matched the SSL VPN user group with the correct username and password details. We are using a remote authentication server, which we are calling Windows AD. And we passed the Acon user information to that Windows AD server, and it came back with the thumbs up. The session received the session cookie, and the Fortigate could find a matching policy, that's policy ID number 2, to enable access from the remote client to the enterprise network. And again, the client received the IP address for its virtual tunnel interface. Back to the client, and just to validate that option, and yes, we have the same IP address assigned to the tunnel interface. Let's disconnect, and the session is terminated, and the session cookie deleted. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.